Here's 5 more free upgrades for your Bambu Lab A1. Let's get into it. First off, we have this really cool, easy to use screen protector that realistically doesn't take much filament and can protect your screen if you need to protect it. Now, this super easy print only takes about 24 grams of filament and about an hour to print. And even better, you don't even need supports for this. I printed this in some Polymaker Polylite PETG in this really awesome dark blue. I really, really like this blue. It just looks awesome. I want to print more with it. But we are going to need to use a little bit of unused filament to kind of connect these two together. So let's get that done. As you can see, what we're going to do is we are going to put some of the unused filament through here to kind of make that connection. And we can cut that off. And we can repeat it for the other side. There we go. And now we have a functioning lid. So honestly, this is just a very simple install. First, we want to make sure that we're going to be flipping it up the right way. We can actually tilt this over a little bit to make it easier. And this just slides on. There we go. Now we have a covered screen to protect the screen in case we need to protect the screen. Next up, this super simple design is purely aesthetic. There's no functionality to this at all other than making your printer look even cooler than it already does. And that is by adding a little fan shroud connector that's a Pokeball. Now I'm pretty sure I printed this in Elegoo's Rapid PETG in red because, you know, I thought the red would be a nice little touch for the Pokeball. This is by VR Design over on Makerworld. You know, it only takes about 1 gram of filament and about 10 minutes to print. But let's get this thing installed. Super easy. All we need to do is literally just pop this on. Fits in perfectly. Oh, I messed up though. We got to get it straight. There we go. Now that looks cool. Most importantly, it's not going to block any of the airflow coming in. And that I think that's a really big important part here. Is the fact that you can add this cool design, but not necessarily restrict the airflow. Next up, I honestly don't know how I really feel about having the AMS light on top of the A1. It is convenient to kind of keep it out of the way, but at the same time, it's really hard to get to the back rolls of filament, especially when you have it up against a wall like I normally do. It's impossible to get back there. It's actually really annoying. I don't like that. Now I'm hoping that I can wall mount this to the wall using this print that I found over on Makerworld. And thanks to Sunlu for sending over some of their more engineering kind of filaments, I was able to print this out in easy PA. And I'm hoping that this is going to be more than strong enough to hold this up on the wall, especially when it's loaded up with filament and whatnot. There's a good chance that if you have an A1, you may not have something capable of printing, you know, a material like this, but that's where today's sponsor comes into play, PCBWay. You could just upload this file straight to PCBWay, select a filament that you can't print with at home, say nylon for instance. You could add this thing to cart and have it delivered to your front door, all while never having to actually buy the roll of filament or even having a printer that is capable of using this filament. Thank you to PCBWay for sponsoring today's video. So now I'm hoping to wall mount this right back here above where the printer sits. Also, let me know down in the comments below if I missed any of your favorite mods. Love to hear what you think. So I imagine this goes on here, just like so. Oof. Now this didn't print perfectly, but I'm hoping it's good enough that it'll still work. I am slightly broken, as you can tell, so this is a little bit more difficult than normal. All right, let me come back to this. I'll be with you in just a second. That was actually kind of lucky. I think I actually found a stud. And now best of all, this just slides on like so. Bam. And now we have a wall-mounted AMS. This is awesome. Still a little cramped back here, but at least Everything is way more accessible. It's way easier to get that things, because before you couldn't even get to those back ones and it was kind of annoying. Now, the A1 doesn't have any storage on this thing, and with this next file, we're gonna fix that. This is an attachment that goes on the front of the Bambu Lab A1 that doesn't get in the way of anything, and it's pretty easy to install. This is a file from Blink3D, who did actually reach out to me asking me if I would feature this if I thought it was cool enough. And, well, I thought it was cool enough, so here we are. Now, I'm fairly certain that I printed this in Polymaker Polylight PLA Blue, which, honestly, I really like this color. This is awesome. This, I got a thing for blue and red. Have you noticed? But this came out great. Let's go ahead and get this installed onto the printer so we can have a little bit of extra space. Now, if I recall correctly, all we need to do is put this here, lift it up a little bit, and it'll actually attach in. And now this just slides in, and that's it. And we can put whatever we want in here, like a whole bunch of extra supplies. Lastly, we have this little build plate aligner, and all it does is basically clip onto the back of the build plate area, and it makes putting the build plate on just a lot easier. Now also, I did print this in that same PETG Poly Light from Polymaker. That is in that dark blue color. Like I said, I really like this. Now, it's really easy to install this. All you do is clip it in right here. And what that does is it gives it a bigger lip for the build plate to contact in and kind of align it to make it a lot easier. And now when you go to put a build plate in, you just, bam, that's all it takes. It's so much easier to do. Definitely recommend this one. Now, I have run into a couple issues with this where it kind of sets off a nozzle clumping detection error. So your mileage may vary on that one. Now that was 5 for this video, but if you want to see 5 more, you really should check out this video right here, because there are some really good free upgrades in that video. I'll see you there.